baby, you are home early. We needed to talk. Or I needed to talk to you. Yes. You see, when we were in Africa, having a baby there was different. We had our three kids, and having a baby there was different. Now we are in America. And I need to call your attention to certain things that you don't seem to pay attention to because of the way it was handled back home. See, pregnant women back home, most of them don't even go to the doctor. So they don't know all the things that are risky for pregnancy. If even they go to the doctor don't care to tell them, do not do this, do not do that, do not do this, do not do that. It's risky for your pregnancy. But since we came to America now, and you decided that three kids is not enough for you, you just like to eat something too much. I told you three kids was enough, but you wanted to eat some more. You forget about toothache. Now I'm pregnant again. So I have to call your attention to this. We have gone to at least 6 appointments and came back home. But what I've noticed is that you are not paying attention to what the doctor said. The things he said that is very risky for me, you're not paying attention to it. The doctor said I should not lift things. I shouldn't lift heavy things, and I should not be stretching my arms. For that reason, ever since we came home, have you ever seen me go hi to somebody? No, I cannot tell anybody hi anymore by waving to them, because when I lift up my arms to wave, it is dangerous for the baby's health. You see, I'm concerned about the baby, and that's why I'm concerned about talking to you. So from now on, there are some things I don't need to do in this America, because it's going to put the baby at risk, baby. You know, here in this America, how many group homes they have. The people here always have reading. Most of the time we see so many retarded babies. They know what they're talking about. Do you want our baby to be retarded? Okay. So, here's the deal. I cannot do laundry anymore. Because to do laundry, I have to pick up the laundry and bring it down. It's you and your three kids plus mine. So the laundry thing is heavy. I have to bring it down. That's heavy. That's a red flag. Number two, when I bring the laundry down, I have to sort it. Sorting the laundry, I have to bend over to sort the laundry. Red flag. I cannot do that. So from now on, you do the laundry. Another thing, I cannot clean the bathrooms. Okay? Because if you remember, the doctor said I should stay away from strong fumes and chemicals. And I always have to scrub the bathroom with something that has bleach, some kind of chemical, baby. I cannot clean the bathroom anymore, okay? To go and just scrub the toilet, I have to bend over and scrub the toilet. See, I can't even bend over right now. I can't do that. You have to scrub the toilet. And as for the bathroom, it's out of the question. That's a huge red flag. I have to get in there and put my hand up to try to scrub the bathroom walls, and then I got to bend down to scrub all in the tub, and then I have to rinse it. Red flags. All those things are red flags, baby. You have to start doing them. I cannot do them anymore. Number three, or number four, whatever number we are on, I forgot. I cannot put my own shoes on. Do you stand up straight to put your shoes on? No. Nobody stands up straight to put their shoes on. Even you sit down, you still have to kind of try to bend down to put the shoes on. So I cannot put my shoes on. Whenever we are going somewhere or we are in this house and I need something on my feet, you have to bring it and put it on my feet so I won't bend down and something will happen to the baby. You see? Yeah, in America, when a woman have a baby, they give her convalescent leave. Over there, none of that. So when I come on my convalescent leave, I've been doing all the cooking in this house. Now you serve yourself very well. I like that. But you have to cook whatever you're able to cook for us to eat, because when I come on convalescence leave, I am supposed to lay down and relax. You are supposed to help me, bathe me, and you are supposed to take care of the baby. So whatever time you, since you are going to work now, don't take any break. Don't take any break from work. Keep all the time you need. In that way, when I come on convalescence leave, you can take at least 2 weeks off and help me to enjoy convalescence leave for the first 2 weeks. And then after that, you will. See, this is not Africa. In Africa, the pregnant women go and fetch water, they fetch wood, they are cooking, they are going to the water side and doing laundry and knocking the clothes on the rack. They are pregnant, but they are doing all this. They are going to the farm and using machete to do all this. Doing all this. It's not right. It's not right. Now we are here in America. So I needed to call your attention to this so that our child can be safe. Eh? Maybe because of their system, the food we eat, I don't know what it is. People have retarded babies around. I feel that they don't listen to their doctor. I don't even think it's only crack and smoking that make the baby retarded. I think especially that cleaning bathroom, smelling the chemicals, I think it's really going to make the baby retarded. Because in Africa, we are okay. We don't have bathroom where we got to go and scrub with chemicals. Half of the time, it's sitting outside. We put gravels all on the ground. We put reeds around here. What is there to scrub? Nothing is there to scrub. If the grass grow into it, it is more privacy. So we don't care about scrubbing anything with chemicals. Now that we are here, and you force me to have a... Well, I will not make you look bad and say you forced me to have a baby. We went to have a baby. We're going to have this baby now. You have to help me because America is different. America is different. Take heed, and do everything I just said if you want the safety of this baby. Because if this baby come out retarded, I want a divorce. And if we have the divorce, I will go ahead and take the 3 normal kids and leave the abnormal kids with you. So if you know what I know, just do what the doctor say, okay? As for you, you are not pregnant. So it is your role to do it. If you don't, like I said, I want a divorce. I will take the 3 normal kids, and then you keep the retarded one. Capiche?